Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to change part of a PNG file to a different color for free online with a software called Photopea. And I want to mention, if you plan on cutting this with a cutting machine and not just doing like a print and cut, if you have an SVG file, it definitely makes way more sense to just use that SVG file instead of using the PNG file to change colors. It's much easier and you'll get a much nicer cut. I actually have another video that shows you how to change colors on an SVG file, and you can see that right up here at the top of your screen. All right, let's get started. Oh, and be sure to subscribe if you want to see more content like this. First, I'm going to show you the easiest way, and that is if you have a transparent background PNG file and the piece that you want to change is not touching anything else. So the order is select, then change the hue and saturation, colorize, and then export. And make sure you don't have a pop-up blocker on or you might lose your work. Okay, so first we'll go to photopea.com. So I'm on Chrome. I'm just going to type in photopea.com. And this link will also be in the description. Then I'll choose Open from Computer. I'll navigate to my file and then choose Open. Now this little grid behind the artwork means that it doesn't have a background. So this is just transparent background back here. I want to select Blessed and this heart, and then the word Teach, and change those to a different color. So I'm going to zoom out with Command minus or Control minus on a PC. And then I'll get this little lasso tool right over here. You can also hit L on your keyboard to get to that. And then I'm just going to draw around carefully the word blessed. And oh, I messed up right there. I don't know if you can see this very well, but I accidentally selected this little bit of these arrows. So now I can hold Option or Alt on a PC to draw around that little bit and remove that from the selection. Now I'll hold Shift to add to the selection, and I'll draw around this arrow. I'll also draw around this arrow, and then I'm gonna have to be really careful right here. Of course, if I mess up, I can always hold Option and draw around the part I messed up, basically, to subtract it. I'll hit Z to zoom in here to see my selection better here. It doesn't look great. It looks like I need to add a little bit here. So I'll get back on my lasso tool. I'll hold Shift. I'm just going to draw around that part to make sure I have that selected. And then I've got part of this E selected on accident. So I'll hold Option or Alt on a PC and draw around this to subtract that part from the selection. I'm hitting Command minus to zoom out, that's Control minus on a PC. And now I have the pieces that I want to change the color of selected. You can see these little lines around them. Now in our layers panel, which is right over here, I'm gonna come down here to where I see a half circle. Half is filled in and half is not. And that's the new adjustment layer button. I'll click that, and then I'll choose hue and saturation right here. That'll make your layer look like this. Next, I'll check the little box for colorize. And now we can change our lightness. I'm going to make it quite a bit lighter. I'm going to make our saturation quite a bit more saturated, and you can see a color starting to come in here. And then you can change the hue, which is your color, to anything by sliding it back and forth. So on this part of the hue, it's light blue, and then as we move to the right, it becomes purple, pink, red, orange, yellow, green, and back to a blue here. I think I want it to be, we'll go with this pink color, but I want it to be more saturated and a little darker. So I can kind of play with these three sliders. Hue is your color, blue, pink, whatever. Saturation will give you how much of that color is applied. If we knock this down, we're getting back to grays. So I want a lot of color, I'm gonna make this 100. And then the lightness of that color can be adjusted here. Okay, so this looks good. Let's export. I'll go to File, export as, and I'm going to keep it as a PNG because with PNG you can have a transparent background. With a JPEG you can't, so all this would turn white, all this background color would turn white. So I'm going to go with PNG. I'm going to keep everything the same and save. Now when I hit save, this is going to go into my downloads folder. Now on Chrome I can click this little folder and that'll bring me to that design and we can see it here. If you're on Safari, the process is probably going to be a little bit different, but it will still end up in your downloads folder. Okay, next I'll show you what to do if you have a white background. And this is just one extra step. You'll basically need to make a transparent background. So this time I'm going to go to File, Open. I'll choose that same design with a white background. And I'll open that. This time we don't see that grid that shows us that it's a transparent background. And I want to have that to be able to change the color easily. So I just want to select the black stuff and not the white. So to do that, I'll hit W to get on my magic wand tool, which is right over here. I'm going to change the tolerance to 15 up here at the top. And then I'm going to make sure this is unchecked, because I want it to select all the black, not just the black that's touching. So I'm on my wand tool. I'm just going to click once on part of the black. And you can see now that you've selected all the black. If you have more than one color, hold shift and then select that other color. Then we'll come over here to our layers panel and I'll hit Command J or Control J to put that selection on a new layer. I'm going to click on my background and just delete that. And now we have our grid back there, which is what we want. Now you can just go ahead and do the process I showed at the beginning of the video. And if you want to jump to that part, the timestamp is right about here. Now let's say I wanted just this H to be a different color. I can also do that with a similar process. I'll use my lasso tool and I'm just going to draw around that H. Now it's going to get tricky right in here because it has to be a really nice selection. Okay, so I have just the H selected. I'm going to zoom in here, and this is a pretty good selection where we're going to change it. Then I'll do that same process. I'll click on the adjustment layer button and choose hue saturation. I'm going to colorize, and now we have a different color here for just the H. We can also play with these sliders like before. And then to export, you would just come up here to File, Export As, and we would choose PNG or any of these other files. And that's it. All right, I hope this video is helpful. If you're still having trouble, just let me know in the comments section below, and also let me know what you would like to learn next. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.